Hi students, coming to the next topic, that is the microprocessor and microcontrollers. So in the previous videos I have explained about the introduction part of the microprocessor and some different evaluations of the processor. Now let us see what is this microprocessor and microcontroller. Okay, so you know that microprocessor is consisting of, it is a single chip. It is a chip, you just call it as a chip. It consists of ALU, registers and control unit present in a single chip. Now coming to the microcontroller, so what do you call by microcontrollers? So a microcontroller unit is, let me write the definition, it is integrated electronic computing device. You call this microcontroller as an integrated electronic computing device that includes three major components on a single chip. So this microcontroller unit is integrated with three major components on a single chip. So that is integrated with microprocessor, memory, input-output ports. So a single chip that is integrated with microprocessor, memory, input-output ports, you call it as a microcontroller, MCU, microcontroller unit. So microprocessor unit means it consisting of ALU, registers and control unit, whereas microcontroller unit means this complete processor is present here. So this complete microprocessor is presented, along with that you are having the memory and all input output ports are integrated in a single chip, then you call it as a microcontroller. So that is the main difference here. Okay, don't be confused. Microprocessor is a CPU, you call it as a CPU. A microprocessor consisting of what? Consisting of, it consisting of registers, ALU and the control unit is present in the chip. So this you call it as a microprocessor. Whereas microcontroller unit is microprocessor plus it's having memory unit and it's having input output ports are all integrated. So these are all integrated in one chip, single chip. This you call it as microcontroller. I hope you understand. Microprocessor consisting of registers, ALU and control unit. So microcontroller is nothing but a processor along with memory and input output ports are all integrated in a single chip. You call it as a microcontroller. So this microprocessor is having some supporting devices. This microcontroller is having supported devices. Some devices are also supporting this chip. Those devices you call it as timers, analog to digital converters and serial input output ports. So this, along with this microcontroller, some supporting devices are connected to this chip. Those are timers, analog to digital converters and serial input output. And also it is having some communication, common communication lines. So to connect each and every components in the microcontroller, some common communication lines is there that call as system bus. So these are the terms that are present in the microcontroller. A microcontroller unit is integrated with the three major components, that is microprocessor, memory and input output in a single chip, that you call it as a microcontroller. This microcontroller is having some supporting devices. These microcontroller connected to supporting devices like timers, analog to digital converters, serial input output device, and some common communication lines, that is a system bus. Now let us see the block diagram of this microcontroller and microprocessor, then you will understand clearly. So this is the block diagram of microcontroller. So what I said, the microcontroller is mainly consisting of three components. So that is microprocessor, memory and input output ports. So along with these chips, some supporting devices will be there in the microcontroller. So those supporting devices are timers, analog to digital converters, serial input output and some other devices. So these are all integrated in a single chip. So this is completely a single chip that is present inside the computer. So within the chip only you are having the processor, memory input output and some supporting devices are all integrated in one chip. So this microprocessor is consisting of ALU, registers and control unit. Everything is there in this microprocessor. So along with this, it is having some memory devices and input devices, output device present in the chip along with timers. So timers, memory is used to store the data and to send the information and it receives the data. So that is that's why it is a bidirectional. Input output ports, input is sending to the processor and output is placed on these ports. So and this timers, so it is indicating some timing information regarding all the buses. So these are the buses. Okay, so these lines you call it as a buses. Buses is nothing but a communication lines. So in the bus, this is a system bus. A bus consisting of address, data and the control bus. A system bus is divided into address bus, data bus and control bus. So address, from where we have to get the data, from where we have to put. And the data bus consisting of what type of data is to be transferred from one component to another component. And the control bus is to controlling these data to transfer to that particular address. Okay, so all components are connected with the help of the bus. A bus is nothing but it's a communication line. It's sending a communication information. Analog to digital converter, serial input output input output device, and some other devices are also connected. The supporting devices are also connected in the microcontroller. So this is a microcontroller block diagram. So whenever you are saying that what is a microcontroller? A microcontroller is consisting of, it is having a three main components that are integrated in a single chip along with some supporting devices. So the three main components that are present in microcontroller or microprocessor unit and memory and input output ports, and along with some supporting devices like timers, analog to digital, serial and other devices which are communicated with some communication lines, that is a bus. So this is about the microcontroller. And I already said that this is a microprocessor. A microprocessor is nothing but it's a CPU, central processing unit, which performs all the operations. So it consisting of arithmetic logic unit, registers and the control unit, which controls all the input output memory and ALU and the registers and the processor. Okay, so the main difference is a processor is having only ALU, registers and control unit, and all other parts are connected externally, external to that chip. Okay, so all, suppose input is unidirectional, input device, okay, and output device, input device, output device and some memory, everything will be present outside the chip, whereas in microcontroller all the chips are integrated within the single chip, that is a microcontroller. Thank you.